whose helicopter pilot, flying over the plains of Oklahoma, spots this large twister.
It's a large tornado. There's some structures there. Looks like it's going to be right in the path here.
And when it hits a farm...
I think it's a pig farm.
There's no hope.
Oh, no.
This aerial viewpoint clearly shows the farm literally being shredded apart while its pieces swirl around the immense vortex.
I'm over several structures, and that one's destroyed.
Keep in mind, these are walls, doors, and roofs being buffeted like confetti.
That's a large tornado. Very large.
Inside those barns are 3,900 head of livestock. Most of the animals survive because their metal cages protect them from flying debris. It only takes moments for this farm to be completely destroyed. People on the ground survive by taking refuge inside of a brick-walled office.
That's the most impressive tornado I think I've ever seen.
2 years earlier, a news helicopter also in Oklahoma captures a tornado approaching an airport.
It's headed right over the airport, right towards a couple of hangars here. It's moving directly to the east, right towards us. We're about a mile and a half from it.
As it gets closer to the hangars, the tornado's winds increase to more than 100 miles per hour.
You can see the wind coming out of the hangars or around the hangars right now. The tornado's getting a little more defined.
As this tornado strikes the El Reno Airport, at least two other twisters are touching down elsewhere in Oklahoma, both from the same storm system.
We got the other funnel coming down to the north now. We've got two tornadoes on the ground right now.
This tornado is extremely rare. It's anti-cyclonic, meaning it's spinning clockwise instead of counterclockwise in the northern hemisphere. That happens less than 1% of the time.
So this tornado's getting bigger. This is El Reno Airport.
The eye of the tornado now looms directly over the hangars and rips the roofs right off the structures, tearing apart the 12 planes stowed inside. The hangars and planes are destroyed, but fortunately, no one was inside. Analysis of these two tornadoes determined that they were only Category F1. Had they been more powerful, these outcomes could have been much worse.